Good morning. It's the Call Flow Radio Show, and you're on the air.
Good morning out there, Farmville. I hope you're waking up bright and shiny, full of energy and ready to conquer the day. I wish that for myself. It does look like it's going to be a pretty darn nice day out there. So get yourself up and get yourself going. John Staten is in the house. Yeah, this is the call.
The Arsenio Hall Show.
That's right. So let's see here.
Guess who's in my posse tonight?
So the Call Flow Show phone number is 434-394-0924. Is it a pet peeve of yours at all if people say zero for a O and an O for a zero and they get those things?
As long as I know what they're talking about. They're giving me like a code to enter into something. I would like to know the difference between the O and the zero.
Me too. I don't know how many times I've looked at that teeny tiny. I mean, it's getting worse and worse by the day. I was looking for a power adapter, 12 volt, blah, blah, blah. I've got a box of power adapters, but I couldn't read half of them because they're so teeny, teeny, tiny.
Yeah, the fine print's getting finer all the time.
That's because everything's getting smaller all the time. No, that's literally Moore's Law says every 10 years technology will be twice as fast, be half the size, and what was the other one? I forgot what the other one is. Oh, yeah, I don't remember. Anyway, he's been right for the last 50 years. So we're all really on the cusp of that, what do you call it? event horizon. Mm. That's what it is. How are you doing today, Mr. John?
So far, so good.
Yes. Well, we got six national days, things we do on this day. I like this portion of our Call Flow Show, but if people want to call and let us know what's going on in their world, if there's something you want to talk about, we would love to talk about it. It's National Hug a Plumber Day, and I'm suggesting you do this randomly. You know, just you know a plumber, just go up to him, hug him, don't explain it at all, smile, walk away. Yeah, you might get arrested later on, but it sounds like a nice thing to do to a plumber. If we have any plumbers out there, let us know what how you'd like to be hugged. I don't know what that means.
What?
Okay, let's move on. It's also National DNA Day. Mm-hmm. DNA fascinates me in so many ways. You know, you remember a long time ago that came out this huge hoopla that they had finally mapped the DNA genome, right?
Right.
Well, once they did that, they figured out they didn't know anything, you know, and so they had to go back and map everything like the proteins, the amino acids, all that stuff. Right. When they finish that, they should be able to print a human. That's all I'm saying. In some way or another.
That shouldn't be a problem.
Just in a bed. You know,
I don't see anything bad happening
no,
with that.
What could possibly go wrong? I saw a sign the other day that we are in the sort of apocalyptic pathway where technology takes over and decides humanity is really...
Ivac.
Y'all.
That's
y'all.
That's where they're going.
Yep. Exactly.
Terminator.
How'd you like those movies?
I love the first one. I initially loved the second one too when it first came out, but I don't know, the first one to me was by far the best, and it was probably because he didn't have a huge budget, talking about Cameron. I feel like directors usually do their best work when they're underfunded and they're fighting against the grain to be creative, yeah, as opposed to, here's all the cash.
Right,
and then they get a little... I'm not saying they get lazy, but if you have all the means to do it, are you really as creative?
Right, and in control of it.
Right, yeah. I don't know. But the first one, even though it's low budget, and some people even just call it a B film.
Yeah.
I don't know. I love that first one. And probably it's also rose-colored glasses. The first one I saw. Now, don't get me wrong. The technology, and I was all in for that second one, just like everybody else. They started losing me after that.
Really? I actually kind of enjoyed the liquid mercury guy.
That's the one I'm referring to, the second one.
Yeah.
Yeah, that wasn't bad. But what I meant after that.
Oh, yeah.
The ones they kept coming out with.
They came out with a mercury Schwarzenegger, didn't they, or something like that?
At one point, they did a CGI. It was all Schwarzeneggers.
Yeah.
CGI'd. And I remember, and I mentioned this to you, and I know no one could care less, but in the first movie, they don't go out of their way to say that all the Terminators look like Schwarzenegger.
Uh-huh.
They even have a dream sequence with Kyle Reese where he's thinking he's back into one of the forts or whatever he's at, and they're underground and all this, and a Terminator gets in. Well, that's not Arnold that's doing the shooting there. It's a buddy of his, a weightlifting buddy of his, Frank Colombo, I want to say is his name.
Interesting.
And so when I saw that as a kid, I thought, oh, yeah, that makes sense. All the Terminators look different because if they all look like Arnold, you could see him coming from a mile away, right?
Who was that? Arnold?
You know my name.
Oh, yeah. I think I'll run for president.
So the second film erased that.
Yeah.
That film said, no, they all look like Arnold. At least that model.
Yeah. And, do you have like a favorite scene in the first one? I have one, and it's just Sarah O'Connor. She's escaping the mental facility, I believe, mm-hmm. and she's got the She's got the shotgun in her hand,
yeah.
and she just does a one-handed load of the shotgun shell.
Okay.
I thought that was so cool. I'd never seen a girl do that before. I'd never seen anybody do that before. But, yeah, so do you have a favorite scene?
In the second one?
Of any of them.
Well, I guess the coolest scene in the second one to me is when she sees Arnold for the first time.
Yeah.
And she's and it all comes back to her, and she's just freaking out. Because he looked, you know, I'm not going to say he looks exactly the same, but he looks familiar enough yeah. to her that she's like, wait a minute, where'd you come from? I'm here for you.
Oh, yeah.
First one, I don't know. I guess the I'll Be Back scene where he takes out the whole police station.
Oh, yeah. What was the movie he did with Jamie Lee Curtis?
True Lies, another good film. Another James Cameron film.
Yeah.
That's a good film.
And about all I can remember of that film is him in a helicopter. She's on the – it's like the end of the
movie. She actually did
movie.
That stunt. She's in a car, and they're on the bridge, and the bridge has obviously gotten knocked out halfway through a bomb, a missile, something. And so that's actually her they got dangling from there. She actually did that stunt.
Cool. They probably tied her on pretty
good. I'm sure
I'd love to do that.
But still, you got to hang from that.
I would do that.
Yeah.
I think that I just
had but you wouldn't look like Jamie hanging from it.
Yeah, I could.
CGI, yeah, man.
No. I've got that dress, so yeah. Oh, my. All right. Certainly we digress. Shall we move on to something more natural and down to earth?
Do it.
Zucchini bread day. That's all I'm saying.
Uh-huh.
It usually doesn't taste like zucchini. It's just like banana bread or anything else. It's got a lot of, I don't know, cinnamon, nutmeg, flavorful things. So you don't, and it's good for you. Especially with some nuts.
We talked about that the other day. Name a food that's good for you that you like to eat. or tastes good. That's what we said.
We are pretty much on the bottom of the barrel for ideas. Let's see. I want to make sure the phone lines are open and working well. The number is 434-394-0924. If you'd like to give us a call, let us know what's going on out there.
Or 0924 if you prefer.
Oh, really?
0924? You said
See,
I'm bringing it back.
I do. Thank you. Thank you for reminding me because that's, you know.
That's a pet peeve of yours.
It is. And I would hate for somebody to be on the phone going, why is it a zero? Is an O? Why? Who put an O? Where's the O? No.
Oh, my.
Okay. Mm. Moving on.
Okay.
National East meets West Day. I'm not really sure what this is about unless it's, I'll look it up. Why not? National East Meets West Day on April 25th commemorates the day the Eastern Front of the Allied Forces met the Western Front on the River Elbe. So that's what that's all about. That happened today in history.
On this day.
National Telephone Day. Mm-hmm. What kind of, when you grew up, what was the least technological phone? Yeah.
I mean, rotary.
Did you have rotaries?
Yeah.
Because you're a young pup, I know. And
I grew up in a house that had older stuff in it, as far as whether it was my grandparents' house or whatever. But yeah, I thought we were really into technology when I lived in Richmond when I was like in the first grade, and we had this red phone with the push buttons on.
Yeah.
I was like, now we're living the dream.
And then you get a super long cord so you can go all the way across the house, you know,
right,
down into the bedroom, basement.
But yeah, I do remember the rotary phone.
Interesting.
Well, yeah, Flo used to have a rotary phone for when you would, this would have been in the 90s even still, they had it when I first worked there. So if we did like a ball game, and you know, I either had to call in or whatever, call the people that were at the game or whatever. That was a rotary phone too, so you still had to know how to use it even in the 90s. So
yes,
it's not that complicated if you're used to it.
I don't know some of these kids.
I said if you're used to it. If you're not used to it, yeah, you're probably like, what in the world is that?
I just had a really good idea. Mm. Oh, wait, I take that
put
back.
Rotary
I just,
phones in here?
I just had an idea. I don't know if it's good or not. We could put the WFLO icon symbol that we have like on the wall here, and then put the rotary buttons all the way around there. Kind of, you know, indication that we're deeply rooted into the community. Isn't that what that would say?
Mm-hmm. I see where you're going.
Maybe not. You can see it, can't you?
I can see
you
it.
You can,
yeah. I can see it. It's all I can see right now.
All right. This is the last day for us. It is National Library Workers Day. Do you think libraries are going out of style?
I don't know.
Do you think they will kind of go under the wayside eventually?
I don't know. Are there numbers that say whether people are reading less? I don't know.
I don't think it's a matter of reading less or more. It's just that they don't have to go anywhere to read whatever they want to read. So
yeah.
So now the library.
I think that's why the libraries have opened up to being more inclusive with activity type stuff.
Oh, good point.
To kind of keep it going.
I wonder if they'll. I wonder if they will. Oh my God! I've become
a California accent.
I've become. WFLO, you're on the air.
Hey, good morning.
Good morning.
I was hoping to get you while y'all were talking about phone numbers and stuff like that, because I have a correction.
Okay.
John, when you do the National Anthem, sometime it is brought to you by Ever Jones, Kirby Moore's office.
Mm-hmm.
I worked for there for a number of years, and I said this number a bunch of times. It's 391.
Okay.
Not 392. So he says it, and anyway, when you repeat it after the song is over, you say 392.
Probably out of habit, knowing me.
Yes. I had to have it plastered across my forehead to learn that it was 391, but it's definitely 391.
Let's see. Here we go.
How does that work? If you plaster it on your forehead, do you have to go to the mirror?
I know.
Do you do it backwards?
As I was saying it, I said, the dumbest thing in the world.
Let me have a pen. No, let me have a pen, Larry, so I can make a correction
of course.
This.
Of course. There you go.
Oops, you know why? Because I typed it as 392 on my live copy, so that's why I'm saying it like that. I'm reading verbatim. 391. We have made the correction. Thank you.
John, we sing that national anthem every morning while we're in here. So we're thinking about trying to get in on a baseball game or something. But so where are you calling from?
Oh, I'm just out Heron Road, kind of between Farmville and Keysville.
Okay.
Not far.
Then are you?
But I listen either on the app or the stream, depending.
Gotcha. Yeah, right. No. Excellent. Yeah, the AM's a little unpredictable at times. So.
Yeah. Plus, I don't have a radio anymore. So.
Well, yeah, most cars don't even have AM radio in them.
Well, they're talking of getting rid of it, or they have. They have made the decision to get rid of it in cars. I think is what I've just heard.
That's what it is.
Mine still has it. It's a 2016, I think.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, I've got one just a year older. I still have it too.
Yeah. None of mine have it, but.
Well, that's because Larry only drives the new vehicles on the market.
I wish. This has been painful, man.
Poor Larry lost his jag.
I know, it's a luxury problem, but hey, it's my luxury problem, and it hurts. Well,
thank you for the correction, by the way.
Yeah, yeah.
Yes. And I was going to say, whether it's a O or a zero, I really hate to be corrected when I say O.
Yeah.
And it's supposed to be a zero.
Hate to be corrected.
O is a whole lot easier to say than zero.
Yes. So I know.
I hate it when somebody says...
Well, that happened to me with reading copy for a commercial. The number ended with two zeros. So to save time, I went double O.
Yeah.
As opposed to zero. You're right. It takes more time to say that. Yeah.
Well, we're all looking for some way to criticize someone else, you know.
Right.
So we can maybe throw that one. Cool. Well, thank you for calling, and I appreciate the correction. Thank you. Oh, by the way, if you don't mind, what's your name?
I'm Sherry.
Hi, Sherry.
She doesn't want to give her name on here. Doesn't want to be associated with us.
No, my twin sister's name is Sherry.
I'm not really Sherry. I'm Sherry. I'm Sandra.
Oh, yeah. No way. You didn't just say that. I swear to God, my older sister's name is Sandra, and my twin sister's name is Sherry. So that's a little interesting.
Yes, but does your twin sister spell it correctly? That's always the question I have to ask.
Her real name is Cheryl Lynn, but she's always gone by Sherry, but she always spelled it S-H-E-R-I.
Ah, I have two R's and an I, and my name is Sherry Lynn.
Really?
Getting weirder all the time.
All right, this is getting strange. A portal just opened over here.
Please don't tell me I'm related to Larry.
That would be a feat worse than death.
It does sound a little frightening right now.
It does. Oh, my God. All right.
Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
Bye.
Bye. I love the laughter in the morning.
Double O's.
That was a little bit on the serendipitous side. That was cool. That was very cool. It reminds me, I'm actually going to my older sister's down in North Carolina this weekend. My son's coming into town, so we're like super looking forward to going down there and not coming in here for a few days. John's like, oh, you're going where? Why are you abandoning me?
Sorry, I won't be here when you get back.
So I have a question. So many things just came to mind so fast. I couldn't process it fast enough.
What were you going to say came to mind?
No, I was just going to ask you some questions about your music taste and stuff. Like, what's your favorite genre of music?
If I had to pick,
you do
probably rock, classic rock.
You do have to pick
classic rock, I guess.
All right. Yeah.
What would be considered classic rock?
That's a good one. How far up do you go there? I know they redesigned.
To me, that's a wide net. I mean, that can be anything. Well, I guess we can say the 80s now, right? Enough time has gone by. 80s all the way up through, I don't know, maybe mid to late 60s.
Okay.
Because to me, you got that bit of era in the 60s where there's a Zeppelin, there's a Who, there's the Cream. And to me, those bands sort of fall in that category.
And they were also like the seeds of rock and roll.
Right. You know? They plant. You're right. Exactly. A lot of the bands that came out later, that was because of those guys.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
You're right.
And nobody could touch them, really. You know, they tried a lot. But
yeah.
I have to admit that my favorite genre is pop. I hate to admit it. I really do. I love classic rock. But if it comes down to it, I like something I can dance to, and pop music's more likely to be danceable than classic rock.
True. And if you had asked me at an earlier point in my life, I would have probably said top 40 music, especially when I was younger, because that's what I listened to. But as the music started to evolve and change, especially by the 90s, I was starting to realize I don't like it as much as I used to, and then I discovered classic rock somewhere in there, and then I was like, this is more my thing now,
because
the pop music's leaving me.
Yeah, okay.
I'm losing interest in where it's going,
uh-huh.
But classic rock stays the same.
The thing that always got me, just, I don't know why, It's when they redefined the Eagles as country instead of classic rock. It was like, it confused me why they would do that. Why did they do that, you know?
You're right.
I would have loved to have seen them in concert. Oh, my God. Actually, I moved up to Boulder, Colorado. I had this big van that broke down all the way moving up there. Mm-hmm. But the reason I was going up there was because there's a studio up there that the Eagles recorded Seven Bridges Road up there. Mm-hmm. I guess it took a months and months just to do the vocals. But my plan of action was I was going to get a job there, even if it was just sweeping floors or something, you know, interning. It didn't matter. I was young. But I got up there. I find a place to live, and I find out that it had burned down.
Oops. So no sweeping needed.
I had to reevaluate my...
You could have swept up the ashes, I guess.
It actually worked out pretty good because I went to recording engineering school up there. Found a little place. And the owner, he would bring in Michael Pfeiffer. And Michael Pfeiffer was related to Michelle Pfeiffer. And he actually brought her into the studio the last day we were there. I had no idea who she was. Back then, just no clue. I mean, I was young.
Before she was in any movies?
No, she was...
She's famous. What was the time frame here at this point?
That's a really good question. It had to have been 85, 86.
Oh, yeah. She was already a deal at that point. Yeah.
Yeah, I missed a great opportunity there.
Yes, you did.
I have other stories I could tell, but this is a fun family.
Fun family.
It's a family station. So, all right. I have a question for you.
All right.
Let's see. Oh, you were talking about being in a band, and so I was curious about how long you were in the band, and what did you do? I mean, you said you played some guitar, but...
Well, yeah, but I didn't do it in the band.
Okay.
As far as how long the band lasted, it seems like to me the band lasts longer when you're in the practice mode than when you get to the performance mode. Because by the time you get to the performance mode, some people, and they might not necessarily be in the band, but have some sort of control over the band, go, okay, enough of that.
Yeah.
You need to come home. Really? I'm not referring to me.
Okay.
I'm referring to other people in the band. So, or whatever the case may be.
Timothy, you get yourself home now.
I'm sick of you hanging out with those guys.
They're a bad influence on you.
But anyway, I don't know. I look at bands like, how many shows did we last?
Uh-huh.
As opposed to the years.
Right. No, that's a good idea.
So, the first one I actually performed in, we probably did maybe five shows. I lose count over time, but...
Right.
And the other one, about... A little bit more than that. We probably did maybe five or six. Funny how it's almost the same level, but the practices seem to be what I remember the most because that's what we spent most of the time doing, practicing and rehearsing.
So what songs did you do? What did you cover?
Oh, man.
And what year was this?
Well, the first was when I was like 26.
Okay.
So that would have been, somewhere in the 2000s? Early 2000s, I guess.
Yeah.
Something like that. And there we were like, let's just do anything we want to do, which would fall in the rock category. So we would do anything like The Who, Won't Get Fooled Again.
Nice.
We would do Halen, of course. We would do...
Some of the easier stuff, or did you have a really good guitar player?
Had a good guitar player. So
that's cool.
And he was a... We liked the same music. We were sort of the outsiders in the band. We weren't because the band was sort of more of a Lynchburg band, I guess you could say. So the drummer was from there, the bass player was from there. We were from Beeham, but it was all right. It did okay.
Cool. That's awesome. But I just realized that we're like at the bottom of the hour, and there's some birthday people out there.
I figured we killed enough time by now.
There's some birthday people out there.
Boring people out there to death.
All right, so should I give a little weather first, or do you want to do the birthdays first?
Yeah, you go ahead, and I'll gather my information here.
Well, it's gone up 1 degree since the last time I talked. It is 43 degrees out there right now. The humidity is 68%. It's northeast, 6 miles an hour, and the barometer is steady at 30.20. I got it right. 2020. It is going to be 65 degrees today with increasing clouds. Tonight, mostly clear with a low of 39. Wednesday, increasing clouds with a high of 71. On Wednesday night, again, mostly cloudy with a low of 45. Thursday gets a little bit complicated. A slight chance of rain after 2 p.m. Mostly sunny with a high near 67. Winds are going to be light at about 6 miles an hour with a 20% chance of precipitation. On Thursday night, rain is likely, mainly after 2 a.m. Increasing clouds with a low around 49. Chance of precipitation on Thursday night is 60%, but it won't be very much, quarter to a half an inch. On Friday, it's rain likely, cloudy with a high near 60, and a chance of precipitation is 70%. Friday night, rain likely, mainly before 2 a.m. That's nice. Cloudy with a low around 52. So that takes us into the weekend. Are you ready for the birthdays?
As I'll ever be.
Well said.
And here we go. Birthdays for today is the 25th, correct?
It is,
okay.
Yes.
My all day, every day. Yeah. Tuesday, the 25th. Happy birthday going out to Nona Summit.
Nona.
N-O-N-A.
Nice.
That's what I'm going with. I had to look this one up. Khadijah Dabney of Cumberland. Hopefully I'm in the ballpark there.
Yeah, I think you are.
And let's see. We have Rita Braxton of Cumberland.
Rita.
James Bland Jr. of Farmville.
James.
I'm sorry. I'm reading too soon. These are for the 27th. They just happen to be on the same piece of paper.
I see.
So let me go back and correct myself. The only birthday officially for today is the Khadijah Dabney of Cumberland.
Even on the calendar thing either?
Well, I'm going to get to that in just a second. See, everything's on a different piece of paper.
You should see John. He's got a magnifying glass.
Sherlock Holmes here. He did. And Nona Summit was for today. So those two names are right for today. And then for the rest of the day, we'll go to the calendar here. And now, here we go. We got anniversaries.
Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah. Like two anniversaries, to be exact.
Wish they'd tell us how long, but...
I don't know. But it has bells next to it.
Hmm?
Okay. Bell and Tanya Wilkerson and Josh and Taylor Cruz. Both couples having anniversaries today. And if you have a birthday today, an anniversary, and we didn't announce it. Happy birthday, happy anniversary.
Absolutely. And I did sort of forget to mention earlier that we have a mascot. It's an avocado. You can see the new mascot, Avocado, on the Facebook page if you'd like to go meet the avocado. The avocado was a little sad yesterday, but he cheered up during the day. And so Mr. Avocado is going to take us through.
He didn't take my cell phone.
He might have. Okay. You might have to reach up in there.
I've been looking. So if you're trying to contact me and I haven't responded, I'm not ignoring you.
There you
go. Just don't know where it's at right now.
It is Tuesday morning, the 25th. Our number here is 434-394-0924. We are your hometown radio station. We'd love to hear from you. So let me see what's going on here.
391.
So if you were a vegetable, what would you be?
I don't know because I don't like vegetables much.
Yeah, but you have
potato.
There you go. On the couch.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. Hey, what, when you were younger, let me put it this way. When I was younger, I was probably 4 or 5 years old, and I remember my dad, who was a music teacher, put a pair of headphones on me, sat me in front of the record player, and turned on Peter and the Wolf. And it was the most amazing experience because there was this pan that went from the left all the way over to the right, and then it went all the way back. Had never realized that sound has an image to it. And so that was kind of the most profound or early memory of music that I have.
Mm-hmm.
What's yours?
Oh, I don't know. The cow goes moo. No, I'm just kidding.
I can't believe you just said that.
It's not actually music. Probably one of those, things where you would crank in there.
Oh, yeah. Jack in the Box.
Yeah, stuff like that.
Did you guys have Jack in the Box here? The food
No, out
chain?
Here it's Hardee's.
Nah. Jack in the Box is Hardee's?
I think Jack in the Box is what they call it out west.
No, it's Carl's Jr.
Thank you. I don't know them. I don't think we do.
Which is drag, because Jack in the Box rocks. I mean, their tacos.
If we do, I've never been to one.
Man, I would kill for a Jack in the Box taco.
But I would see commercials for it, but that was always on satellite. So I was probably watching TV from another city.
Right from California, where people are cool and...
As opposed to here. You can call Larry now at 434 394 0924. Am I even right? I'm sort of blind here.
I'm just kind of trying to see what might be. What's your favorite concert? Actually, I've been to a lot of concerts with Alicia and before, but I saw Muse, and it was just the most amazing concert I had ever seen. We were down in the pit. We were like 3 feet from the musicians and everything, but it was amazing. I love Muse, and it was far beyond my expectations. What's your favorite?
I guess favorite and memorable are two different things. Memorable would be the first real rock concert that I remember wanting to go to, as opposed to being dragged to, and so that would have been Van Hagar, because Hagar was in the group at the time, and this was in Landover, Maryland, and it would have been the first concert I would have had the chance to go to. Dad took me. I even got to leave school early. He picked me up because we had that far to go. It was the Civic Center, if I remember right. But favorite? Oh, it had to be probably the first time I saw Dave with Halen when they did the Get Back Together tour. I loved that. It was like 08, 07, something like that. Or 07, 08. that was something I never thought I was going to see. I thought that would never happen. As much bad blood and how much they used to talk about each other and all that sort of stuff. I was like, there's no way in the world this is going to happen.
Just goes to show that money is stronger than love.
Money cures all.
Hey, guys, our bank account's getting a little low. What do you say we give him a call?
Let's get old Dave back.
Hey, Dave, you ate one too, huh?
How's the news about?
That's funny. Alrighty then.
I got a way we can make big money. We're gonna get together, man, and rock and roll.
I just, for some reason, a question just popped in my head. If you were to work at a circus, what would you do? What job would you have wanted to have? Did you ever want to just like take off and join the circus? And I mean, my parents threatened to sell me to the circus quite often, but
probably the take off part. I don't know about the circus part. I don't know. I guess I'm trying to think of a cool job in the circus, and not the lion tamer. No. I don't want to be a clown.
How about a elephant pooper picker upper?
No. I do enough of that around here.
Super duper.
I don't know. I don't want to be one of those tram, where you have to catch the people when they're swinging the trapeze artist or whatever you call it and all that sort of stuff.
Fly through the air with the greatest of you.
Catching girls would be fun, but I don't know if I want to do it 30 feet in the air.
Catching girls, that sounds funny. Like the falling out of the sky. Ah, I got
one. They do in that act.
Yeah,
right?
That's a good point.
When they're swinging back and forth.
Oh, my goodness.
Now, I don't know. I guess what would suit me would be the barker, the guy that comes out and says, ladies and gentlemen, blah, blah, blah.
That would be you, wouldn't it?
That'd be more me, I guess.
You'd fall right into place there.
There's no danger in that.
Well, you're a walking cartoon as it is.
Pretty much. Well, I've been told that before.
Yeah, by me at least 5 times. No.
Walking cartoon.
All right. Then what magical power would you have?
Now, that's
you got to choose.
And if it was just one, that's tough.
It is. I've been watching Lock and Key. It's a bit juvenile.
Because I would want to initially go to flight, but I tell you what, there'd be something there about super strength that I would really like. But flight, think about it. You wouldn't need a car. And there goes a lot of cost just out the window right
there.
Buying the car, keep buying money for the car, the, the upkeep of the car.
So I have a better idea. Invisibility. Because you could just get into anybody's car at any time. So you wouldn't have to have the car, and you'd still have it. I mean, think about what you could do with invisibility. What would you do with that?
I don't know. I've watched not the original Invisible Man. What was the one that Kevin Bacon did? It was sort of like a Glimmer Man. I don't remember what it was called now.
I don't remember that.
But it had
maybe somebody out there
had Elizabeth Shue in it. That made it seem kind of freaky to be the invisible. Well, in the original, didn't the Invisible Man go insane?
Well, we all go insane eventually.
I do remember. Did you ever watch the film Amazon Women on the Moon? It was a comedy thing. It was nothing but skits all spliced together.
No.
There's a very funny scene where it was Ed Begley Jr., I believe.
Uh-huh.
He's like the son of the Invisible Man. And he thinks he has recreated the whatever to give him the ability to be invisible. But he's sick in the head. He's not really invisible, but he thinks he is.
Oh, that's great.
So there's a whole scene in the bar where he's walking around naked and moving and moving things on people's table going, ooh, and all this sort of stuff. And the whole time the people are just sitting there looking at him like, because he does it all the time.
Right.
And it's like, oh, look, it's the Invisible Man and all that sort of stuff.
I love that premise. I really do. I've seen that with other things, but not the whole movie. That's what's it called again?
Amazon Women on the Moon. The same, I think it's the same people that did the Kentucky Fried movie or something.
Okay.
Very similar. It came out before that. But
What time frame are we looking at?
Amazon was probably in the 80s.
Okay.
Early to mid 80s. Kentucky Fried movie. I don't know if that's late 70s, early 80s. I'm not sure.
So what's the best indication for you when you're watching a movie about what year it is?
Probably like the music, 80s, I guess.
Yeah.
As far as what, knowledge of it?
No, I was thinking what I do, I look at the cell phones and see what, you know, version of iPhone they have. And so I know what era that they're going for in that space and time.
Well, there's always these signs, the clothes, the hairdo, the car.
Yeah.
The
well,
cars.
And some of them are period pieces too. So you got to kind of limit
right,
that.
I'm not including those. Like if you watch a Burt Reynolds movie, say, we won't go with Bandit. We'll go with something more obscure like Seamus. There's a movie he did called Seamus. That's very very 70s. You just. As soon as you it starts, you're like, yep, I know what era this is.
Did you watch Game of Thrones?
No, but I know what you're talking about.
Okay, the scene where she's walking naked through the streets and there's this like nun behind her doing water on her back and just going, shame, shame.
Okay.
Me and Alicia do that all the time. We're like, shame.
Shame.
We have our own little things now, don't we? Yeah. All right. If animals could talk, who do you think who do you think would be the rudest animal?
Rudest?
Yeah. Maybe a wild boar. What about that?
Huh? I don't know. What animals have bad personalities?
I don't know. Humans? Oh, yeah. That's what it would be. Humans. Human. Oh, but just think of what a squirrel, if a squirrel could talk, do you think it would have a really high voice or a really low voice?
I would think high.
I think everybody would. I don't even know why I asked that question.
Unfortunately, Rocky and Bullwinkle made that seem that way, I guess. Hokey smoke, Bullwinkle.
Oh, my. Oh, let's see here. This is kind of interesting. My last name is Burr, right? Or as
yeah,
you
Burr.
Would. As, yeah, thank you very much. So when my son was born, we were, you know, going through names, and I wanted to name him Tim, you know. But
Timber! And that's why you went against it?
Yeah, you know, eventually my wife caught on, and she just didn't accept that. We actually named him Jazari, which is a fantastic name, but Tim... Hey, it's Tim Burr in the house. So what would you name your kid?
I don't know. I don't know. Amazing, impossible. What?
Yeah, I was going to say, why? Why?
No, I don't know. I'd probably take the easy way out. Call him. Give him my name. I wouldn't give him my name. I don't know. I don't know.
You're the third, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Ah, so fourth would be...
John Four.
Nice. That's nice. So was your grandfather here in Virginia, or where?
Yeah,
where's
yeah.
He,
he lived in where I'm from, Dillon.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
you're just all the way home, aren't you?
Yeah, never really left local yokel, except for that 1 year when we lived in Richmond. That was it.
Has your phone been slowing down at all?
I don't know. I don't have it.
Oh yeah. I'm experiencing.
It slowed down so much. It's not here.
I'm experiencing it everywhere, like ghost in the machines, and it seems to be just getting a little worse and a little worse, but I'm sure we're just getting attacked. I don't want to be dramatic, but there are constantly those things going on our internet. Could you imagine not having the internet, or what would happen if
the
internet...
Yeah, because I remember a time when there wasn't.
That's true. We do know what it is. But
I'm old enough to remember that.
I sit there, and I'm looking at my phone, and I'm getting sick. Looking at my phone, I got to put this thing down. But no, there's just too much information out there.
I know it sounds crazy to anyone listening, or the fact that I don't know where my phone is.
Yeah, really.
Much less left the house. I figured I left it here, to be honest with you. Uh-huh. And of course, I get here and it's like, nope. So it's somewhere tucked away in my room, I'm
or,
assuming.
Or I found it and hid it really well.
Well, then there's that. but my world doesn't come to an end. The only thing I do think of, the people that are trying to contact me and can't, or I'm just not receiving those. But I was always famous for leaving the cell phone behind, and it's not something I really... I used to even make jokes about... on Facebook, they had this thing there for a while where you could make yourself into a cartoon.
Oh, yeah.
And then you...
Give yourself an avatar.
Yeah, and then they put you in these scenarios, or you could choose a scenario and then uh-huh. put a caption and stuff like that. So one caption was all these people looking down in their cell phones.
Yeah.
And I'm just walking along, and I'm like going... And I think I wrote something like, John's the only normal person left. Something like that.
That's great. That's fantastic. Oh, I'm trying to think. Ouch. I got bit by a wasp yesterday.
Yeah, you mentioned that.
And that thing just will not stop itching.
Yeah.
They've all been like that. It's like 3 days you have to do it, and then it goes away. But, man, you've been bit by a wasp.
Oh, yeah.
The wasps here are insanely big, too. I mean, it's strange.
They're all big out here, boy.
The squirrels seem small, though. That's what's strange. Squirrels are small, and
the
bugs are big.
The wasps take up all the room and the space and the food. And
all right, we should get back to maybe some music ideas. Do you have any artists that you think are underrated?
Underrated?
I know. That's a tougher one. We're always looking at overrated, but underrated seems to be...
Like artists that could have done more than what they did type of thing?
Yeah. I just wish they had done more, I guess, could be the question.
Well, Minute Work was sort of a phenomenon type group.
Yeah.
They hit it really big at first, and then somewhere along the way they just went away. But I thought they were really good.
Yeah.
They came up with some good tunes other than just the ones that get played to death, which one was this morning I played. Who Can It Be Now? The other one is the one that's probably my least favorite of the one. Not that I don't like it. It's just my least favorite is the Land Down Under. Because it just got played to death.
Yeah, it did.
And it's not a bad song, it's just, but...
Well, when it first came out, it was great.
Right.
I mean, it was so much
But I like
fun.
Other songs they've done, like It's a Mistake, there's another, Overkill.
Yeah.
It's a good song.
Yeah.
They did other good songs. Sort of like Rick Springfield. Rick Springfield was really huge in the 80s, obviously, but by the time, like in current day times, 10 years ago, if not further back, the satellite that Flo used to have... They'd only play Jesse's Girl, and that's it. And I was like, the man had other hits. Why have you... This man will only have one song
played. A lot of them. too. I mean, I'd love to know how many he actually had.
Billy Squire was somebody whose career was kind of pulled out from under him just because of some goofy video he did. And
it was the video that did it?
Yeah.
I thought it was drugs.
No, supposedly he did a video for Take Me in Your Arms or whatever the song is called. I don't even remember what the song is called.
Oh, John. Yeah, okay.
Nah. But anyway, in the video's premise was nothing more than him and the premise. When I give you the premise, you'll go, yeah, that would do it. He's dancing around in his bedroom and on the bed and all this other stuff.
Yeah. He was high energy, that's for sure.
Yeah, but it doesn't look right.
Okay.
There's a grown man just sort of dancing around.
Kind
of in his, I don't want to say his pajamas, but...
I wonder who recorded. I mean, was there like a video of him doing that?
Well, that's what the video was.
Oh, okay. It's a video.
Yeah, the video is actually.
Now I'm really scared because I dance around.
Rock Me Tonight or whatever the song is called. Anyway.
I don't see why that would hurt him. I mean.
Oh, I think it killed that rock kind of, I'm the rock guy image.
Oh, really?
I don't, you know, it's like seeing somebody from AC/DC dancing on a bed or something like that. I don't know about that one, guys.
Yeah. I mean, we put personalities on to people, you know, in their songwriting, and you can get a little bit of an idea. There's obviously writing their songs, but I bet 80% of the time we're totally wrong on what they are really are like.
Probably.
I mean, they're all just people. We're all just people. So do you still buy records or CDs or anything?
I'm more of a CD type person. Records to me were something that could get were too delicate.
Do you want to bet this is our first time caller?
It might be. They scratch easy. They break
Hello,
easy.
First time caller. Sorry about that. The signal got lost there. If you want to try again later. That would be great. If there's anybody else out there that would like to talk to us, the number is 434-394-0924. Did we talk about the wine festival yesterday and how that went off? And
I was going to ask you, since you went, how was it? What you got to experience and what you saw?
We went pretty early, so we kind of cruised around. We don't drink, so
right.
It kind of loses us.
Yeah.
But the big thing there was the band, and unfortunately, I couldn't get back to listen to the band, which is really what I wanted to do.
Uh-huh.
But they did have good vendors around. But what I heard later was that there was only, they lost, I think, a wine vendor or something. So there was only two vendors serving wine.
Oh, wow.
And the lines were long, like first-time caller told us. So, maybe they'll readjust that. But I bet trying to change days must have been a nightmare.
And changing the days that late probably did have an effect on it.
Yeah, and somebody said that they'd put them up on the pavement right above the park there. And that was just different than what it's been like. So... all in all, though, I got this really nice feeling that it was a fun event, that people were excited to be there and enjoying it. So I wish I had put up my art booth. I think I would have done all right. You know, people drinking enough wine, they'll buy anything. We love those.
Oh, there's a painting.
It looks like a turtle. I like turtles. Did you ever see that meme? I love turtles. Oh, you got to look it up, man.
If I have, if I don't remember it.
Yeah, you wouldn't forget it if you saw
it. You wouldn't forget it.
It was so big. What do you think about memes anyway? I mean, do you see them much?
If I do, it's because they're on Facebook or something. But I don't go on Facebook as much as I used to.
So I kind of miss – this is why I miss my son, because he's always – we were always watching memes together. And he'll send me some every once in a while, but he's doesn't do that.
But, if they're done right and they're done in a way that I find them funny, I like them.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Absolutely. They're I don't know why. I just thought about TikTok and the controversy around TikTok. And it's kind of like – it's almost like politics. People are like, TikTok, go. And the other people are like, oh, no, it's evil. It's going to kill us all. So I don't know whose voice that was. And I've actually been conflicted on this whole TikTok thing. As soon as they said that they were going to outlaw it, though, then I downloaded it, of course, because that's not something the government should do for us. Unless it's a truly deep, deep – attack or something, and I don't see it.
I pledge ignorance on the. is it because they're afraid that your information can get hacked?
Like that. This is why I find it funny, is because everybody is watching you. I mean, do a clean on your. There's a free CC cleaner for your PC, and it. It will clean out all the cookies that are in your registry. Mm-hmm. And cookies just sit there and they talk to whoever created this application or whatever. And so they're taking that information all the time. So I don't see where or how TikTok is worse than anybody else. I literally had 20,000.
It's probably because our government doesn't have control over it.
Well, it could be.
Another government does, and therein lies the problem.
But that's the thing. I don't think
I'm joking, government, by the way.
No. We do that all the time. Like, we say something, we pick up the phone. But what kind of world are we in now that we do that, you know, where we have to talk to our phone and tell it that we're just joking, you know? Do AIs understand? Seriously. I mean, you could put stuff together and
I miss the days when only Bond was being bugged in a room.
And Bond was being bugged.
James Bond.
Yeah, Bond was being bugged.
Yeah, where he would have to look under the lampshade and the phone and all that sort of unscrew the rotary phone.
Absolutely. That was great.
And the speaker.
Ah, the good old days.
The good old days. Let's see who's bugged me now. Quit bugging me.
I forgot. Did I ask you what your favorite movie was?
Favorite movie of all time?
Yeah.
Well, I'll play the easy way out. Superman.
Well, that's cool.
The motion picture, the first one, Chris Reeve. But I mean, there are way.
It's a deep well.
Yeah, that's too hard, especially for somebody like me that really enjoys a lot of movies. It'd be hard to, but the one that gets me is that one for sure, because I've been watching it ever since I can remember. I get that feeling of kid mode again when I see certain that scene where he first does the rip open the shirt and saves Lois from the helicopter.
Yeah.
That one, man, when that music would kick, I was like, goes up, you know.
It looks like it's about time for us to wrap
up. Yes, it
does. Lovely morning talking to you and you out there in Farmville. John Staden is coming in.
It doesn't roll off the tongue like, burr.
No, it doesn't. Staden. Have a fantastic day. Thank you. Dig 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 day. Thank you.